Why is it that we Africa, we don't love to support our brothers or our sisters that is trying to climb? We don't really like to support them, especially not in Europe, not in Europe. I'm not talking about Europe, especially Africa, because some of our young brother, young sister, I always see on Facebook, Instagram these days, the way that they are struggling, the way they are really learning skills in their hands, is like many people will go there, ministers, senators, they will go there to promise heaven ahead that, ah, this is what we want in our country. Oh my God, we are going to support you. We are going to do this for you. Then we just yob. The next thing, they will go and never to come to that place again. I don't know why we don't like to really train somebody in our country so that we cannot be going everywhere, borrow. Okay, my people? So that is what we will be talking about today. Hello, people. How are you all doing? Happy Christmas, guys. Happy Christmas in advance. Okay, my people? How are you all doing? And happy, blessed new month. Month of breakthrough, month of good health, month of success, etc., guys. Okay, so my adorable people, in case you are new in my channel, okay, my name is Maria Omo Family TV. What I do in my channel, I always deliberate on Ghana, Nigeria. I always do aproko, gossip, anything, okay? I am a blogger, okay, my people? So that is what I do in my channel. So guys, you all that always tune into my channel to watch my video, trust me, guys, how Jehovah, I am not taking any of you for granted. I love you all with the love of God. Keep on pushing me, keep on supporting me, guys. As you do so, may God bless you. Okay, let's dive on it, my people. Today's video, guys, is a new guy from Takrade in Ghana. When I listen to this young guy, I hear evil. To start with, guys, when I see what this guy is really doing in Takrade, Ghana, I was just like, oh my God. Like, seriously? You know, sometimes when we buy a car, we will be saying, this is German machine. This is German machine. This is German machine. This is Tokyo machine. This is Philippine machine, etc. Italian machine. Do you guys know that those people that is doing those machine, they started like this young guy from Takrade, Ghana. They started like this. You know, one thing I come to study from these white people, all these white people we are living with, when you are useful to the society, when you want to get a beautiful life, you really want to become something in the society, they are just going to train you, support you to make sure you achieve that your big dream. But if you choose to be useless, they will just say, okay, go and useless. But I don't know where we Africa, we have those, I believe, this very guy that is doing all these cars, all this key, a lot of things, guys, etc. If you see what this young Ghanaian from Takrade is really doing, my people. I was just like, but he pains my heart when he started to narrate his own story. Minister always come to him, big people, top people in Ghana, they always come to his shop, because where he lives, where he do those things, he's very small that he needs help. But they will come to promise him a lot of things. At the end, they will not come back again. Ha! Ha ha! It's not really good though. It's not good when we have people that have skills. We have to support those kind of people. We have to take them to the next level so that foreigners will still be coming to our own land to come and buy from us. Yes, my people, we don't need to neglect those kind of people. Look at what this guy is really doing. I believe if it is abroad, that guy is really doing this kind of thing. Ha, Jehovah. Jehovah, the way they will support that guy, the way where they will put that guy, where they will put him, eh, to really accomplish that his big dream. But we Africa, we keep dreams. I should not just talk. That is Ghanaians, they try a little bit, they try to empower people, they try. But where me, I am coming from Nigeria. If you have dream, if it is not the grace of God, they will kill that dream for you. Hey, they will kill that dream. Because I always see some of our Nigeria youth, especially from the east, they will create a car, they will architect, little guys, they will use cartoon to create architect, everything. But nobody, when I see those kind of things, it hurts my heart. Nobody is really supporting them. Nobody is pushing them. Nobody is empowering them. And we have big boys in Nigeria. Big boys. I know they cannot just, they can't reach everybody. But when you see those kind of people that have dreams, that can support the society when they make it in life, those kind of people, we need to support them. We need to be pushing those kind of people. It's high time they will bring somebody from our country and say, this person did this, this person did that, play, do train, you do, etc. Not every time what we always hear, they kidnap somebody, they give somebody a RIP. We don't want to be seeing that anymore. We have intelligent Nigeria in our country. We have it. But they are not empowering them. They are not. Later they will say they are lazy. Our Nigeria boss, they are not lazy. They are not lazy. Just there is no support. No support at all. That is just the problem. Unemployment everywhere. You will go to school at the end, you can't find a job. Maybe you will say you want to study medicine in the school. You want to be an engineer in the school. They will ask you to go and bring million before they can give you that course. Hey, Jehovah. And when you don't have that money to give, trust me, you will switch to another course that is not your own. That is not the same agenda with what you really want to become. That's why unemployment everywhere. Unemployment. It's high time they talk. Guys, it's high time our president, our senators, they do something about those kind of things. When you want to take course, when you are qualified to take that course, so be it, you go for it. Not you pay million before they will not give you that course. Let's just keep that one aside, okay? This our young Ghanaian from Sakra Day. Please, we have to support this brother because that is what this guy is really doing. If it is European that have that kind of person, Jehovah, he like the better. But we Africa, we always like to press those kind of people. I don't know why. I don't know why, guys. So if you know you have not subscribed to my channel, kindly do. As you do, may God bless you. Try and watch till the end and see how this guy explain what he's passing through and see amazing things that this guy is really doing. The beautiful skills and talent this guy really have. Oh my God. Ghanaians, please, you guys have to support this brother. You guys have to. I pray this video really touch people to stand up and help this guy, okay? So that we have our own. People will be coming to buy from us, okay, my people? Our name will be everywhere for good. Our marker, everything will be everywhere, okay? See Louis Vuitton now. That marker is coming from Paris. See Dolce & Gabbana is coming from Italy. So we want to create our own marker that will be coming from our own Africa land. We Africa, we are strong, okay? So, guys, watch till the end, okay? Share this video. Share this video. Please share it. So watch till the end and see how this guy narrated the whole story. So, guys, and I would love to see you all in my next video.
I pray to God to change the black man mindset that he should support his own. My name is Asidu Abudu. People always call me Inventor One from Ghana. Here is Western region. I do so many things here. I invent cars, electronics, gadgets like voice transmission system, door alert. Let's say if somebody tried to open your door, the machine that can give you signal on your cell phone. I do this type of cars, like Wrangler, old cars, saloon cars, and other things.
Africa number one inventor, live from Tabra, Ghana.
I do so many things here. Voice transmission system, eating machine, maize planting machine, a lot. I do so many things here. This one is a padlock, electronic padlock. This padlock works like, let's say, if you put this padlock on your door and there's an intruder or somebody tried to open it, this padlock will give you signal on your cell phone anywhere you are. And the other one to use, let's say, if somebody, the time that they open the door, this padlock will record the time. So let's say if you ask somebody to go and open your store for you and the person get there, the time the person open it, this padlock will record the time. So anytime you the owner of the shop, you get there, the padlock will show you the time that they open. So let's say you are in Accra and your store is in Takoradi and somebody open it. Anytime you get to the office, the padlock will give you signal that they open the padlock at this time. This is how the function of this padlock. This car used three tires. You have two tires at the front and you have one tire at the back. This car used 5 gears. So let's say if you are going to beaches and all that kind of stuff, you can use this car. And a very, very nice car. When the car is coming, you see the engine first before you see the car. And this one, this car is designed in Takoradi. I have this one. This one just for cargo. If you go to Abosoka and they use this kind of Abosoka machine, the Abobo here, so decided to design one in Ghana here. So this one is made in Takwa. You take your boots, cement, gloves, any items that you know you can use this car to. So many work there, even farmers, this northness can use the, this car to take the yams and all that is. You see, this car is a nice portable car. This car takes only 2 passengers. So let's say if you are going to some beaches and all that stuff, you can use this type of cars. The Ghana student can use this car, individual can use it. So if you have this car in your house like this, you will enjoy it. The challenge that I have with this type of work, in Ghana here, if it is what the European or the white, if you have any idea or the government or the individual that they have, they will support you. But in Ghana here, it's not like that. Ghana here, even I've speak to a lot of big men, a lot of government officials, even some of the ministers visit my site. They will promise you they will do this, they will do that to you. But when they leave, that is all. You see. And things like this, every material that you're going to use to design this kind of stuff, you have to go and buy it. If you get to the market there, you will not tell the person who is selling the material that you are the inventor, so they should give you free. You have to buy. And how are you going to get the money? A lot of Ghanaians, when they see my video on YouTube and listen, the youth, they used to call me inventor one, you want to come and learn from you. See the place that I'm working now. The shop is too small for me. So if I'm going to take, let's say, 10 boys for you, you can't use this shop. That's why every day I just agree to the public or the government official that they should come and support. Because the Africans or somebody like me, I have so many ideas. I can do a lot to help the country. You see, sometimes if you sit on the, you sit to watch the TV and you see what is going on in Ghana here, there's a lot of problem that you, the inventors, can solve it for them. But the politicians will not allow you because they will come and talk to you. When they see some people around, they get promise, oh, you come and build shop for you, they will come and do this for you. The Minister for Science and Technology, the former one, Professor Fufopati, he visited my place 2 times. He promised me, asked me to even design one of this thing, what do you call it? Abobo here for him. I did it for him. I sent the gadget, the machine to the Minister for Science and Technology. Up to date, getting to 2 years, I've not heard about it. You see the problem now. So if a youth like this, I want to work, I want to support my country, I want to help the whole world. But you will not get any support from anybody. That's why I agree to the world that if anybody out there, other outside Ghana or anywhere in this world, the person can come and support in Benin, I want to see what I will do. Master, I do so many things here. My humble advice to the African leaders that they should support their own, because this European, the foreign companies, when you bring them down to your own town, if you ask these big companies, manufacturing companies, to bring their factories into your country, you have to support your own factory.